Continue working on your file from the last movie. If you need to, you can also use the file name cityblocksbuildingsbake.max you downloaded for this tutorial. As you work with Building Maker, each element you create at any given level carries with it a fair number of modifiers and other constraints. These are essential for Building Maker to work properly, but do require a fair amount of calculations to process. For that reason, you can help with calculation time by stripping the building down to a poly object when you are done with the design. Remember to do this only when the design is complete. To extract the building as a separate poly object, you start by selecting any part of it. You then use the Bake Building button in the Building Maker UI. A dialog appears. Here, you have two options. One option is the Bake button, which extracts all the building information into an in-project editable poly. You can then place that duplicate anywhere you want. Note that the duplicated building has no connection to the Building Maker interface and cannot be edited that way. The original building is still in place. If you do not need it anymore, select any part of it and use the Delete Building button to remove it. A warning reminds you that this operation cannot be undone. The other method of baking a building is the Bake and Export to Fbx method. The advantage of this method is that it lets you store individual buildings or groups of buildings externally as Fbx files. This means you can now use import procedures to re-import them into 3ds Max or other 3D applications. Try it on the high-rise. Select an element of that building and then click the Bake and Export to Fbx button. You are prompted for a location and a file name. Choose those accordingly. Once the file is saved to disk, you can dismiss the Building Baker window. To test it out, try importing the high-rise back into your scene. Use the Add method to add it to the current scene. The Fbx file is imported, but the new building is not showing the textures in the viewport. You may have noticed when you unpacked Building Maker that there was another .ms file available named postfbximport.ms. With the imported building still selected, run the new script to take care of the textures being shown in the viewport. Actually, the script does a bit more than that and fixes some scaling discrepancies. This is mostly important if and when the imported Fbx file and the current scene are not of the same scale. Using the techniques shown in this movie, you can now easily create a library of buildings that you can use to add to your city blocks. An example is shown in the city named cityblocksbuildingspattern.max, which you'll use shortly as you put the city blocks in context. This completes the building creation part of this tutorial, so you can close the Building Maker UI. Now you have three city blocks with a variety of buildings scattered about. In the next movie, use various techniques to tile the city blocks in an irregular pattern.